This is my last example of source transformation theorem. I take this problem from this book, Fundamental of Electric Circuit, whose writer is Charles K. Alexander and Matthew N. O. Sadiku. And the problem number is practice problem 4.6. It is a practice problem and there was no solution given for this problem. Now here for this circuit we have to use source transformation theorem to calculate the current through this 7 ohm resistor. So what is source transformation theorem states? Source transformation theorem states that if we have a voltage source in which a resistance in series, let's say the series resistance is RS and the voltage is VS, I can convert this voltage source and series resistance to an equivalent current source and resistances in parallel. And what will be the value of current? Let's say current source is IS, current source current will be IS equal to VS divided by RS, and the resistance will have a value of RS. And second one is, if we have also a current source and is a parallel resistor, then I can also convert that into a voltage source with a resistance in series, and the voltage source will have a value of VS equal to IS into RS. Now what does source transformation theorem states? Source transformation theorem tells us that when we have a voltage source with a series resistance, we must convert that voltage source and resistance into a current source into parallel resistor. And if we have a current source with parallel resistor, I have to convert that current source and parallel resistance into a voltage source and a series resistor. Let's say the terminal, this terminal is our terminal A, and this whole path will be terminal A, and this is our terminal C. This is terminal B and this is terminal C, as we are moving along the same wire. So this will be terminal B and this will be terminal C. Look at the terminal A and C. You will see that a 5 ampere current source is connected in parallel with two resistance. One is 3 ohm and another is this 6 ohm. That means if I rearrange these resistances, I will take this 6 ohm resistor in the right side of this current source, and this gives our first simplification of the circuit. I just exchange the place of current source with this 6 ohm resistor. Now look, this 6 ohm resistor and this 6 ohm resistor and these 3 ohm resistances are connected in parallel. That means I can reduce, if this is terminal A and this is terminal C, I can reduce these two resistances into their single equivalent parallel resistance. And now look here, between the terminal B and C, this 1 ohm and this 4 ohm resistances are connected in series, so I can add them up to give a total resistance of 5 ohm, and this whole circuit and this will be replaced between the terminal B and C. In our next simplification, I will convert these two resistances into a single resistance. See, if I take the equivalent parallel resistance, then I will get a value of 2 ohm. Now look at the terminal A and C. You will see that a 5 ampere current source is connected in parallel with a 2 ohm resistor, and a 3 ampere current source is connected in parallel with 5 ohm resistor. Now we will attack this current source and this resistance and this current source and this resistance, and convert this current source and resistance to a voltage source with a series resistance, and convert this current source with a resistance in series. If I convert them, and the voltage source and the resistance will be placed between the terminal A and C, where these current source and resistances are connected, and here also the voltage source and resistances will be placed between the terminal B and C. Now if I convert this voltage source, I will get voltage source VS equal to is into rs. See here we have is equal to 3 ampere and resistance equal to 5. That means I will get a voltage of 15 volt. Look at here, we have a voltage source V. If I convert this into a voltage source, then I will apply Vs equal to Is into Rs. What is the value of I? 5, and I is equal to 2. So I will get a value of 10 volt in this path. Now see, between this terminal and this terminal, this 7 ohm resistance divide this circuit into two portion. One is in the left side and another is in the right side. And in this, with respect to this terminal, I will see that this 10 volt and this 5 volt source are supplying current in the same direction. That means if I they will be in series, and I can reduce these two into a single voltage source, and that will give this circuit another simplification. See, if I add this voltage source and this voltage source, I will get a total value of 15 volt. I will get a value of 15 volt in the right side, left side, and all other remaining circuit will remain same. Now look at the terminal, this terminal. Let's say this is our B terminal and this is our C terminal. You will see that in the right side we have a voltage source in series with 5 ohm, and in the left side we have a voltage source with a series resistance. That means I can convert this, the portion that is connected between this terminal, into a current source and a series resistance, and the portion that is connected between this region to a current source and a parallel resistance. And if I convert them, I will get a circuit like this. This I will get Is by using this law, Vs divided by Rs. What is Rs? Rs equal to 2 ohm and Vs equal to 15 volt, which gives us a value of 7.5 ampere. And here if I convert this, I will get Is equal to Vs divided by Rs. That means I will get a value of 3 ampere. So, and the direction, always careful about the direction of current. See here, the voltage source is supplying the current in upward direction, so my current source will also supply in the same direction. See, the voltage source is supplying the current in this direction, so I have to give the direction of current source in upward direction. Now if this is a, I consider this whole terminal a single node. I will consider this whole terminal a single node, and in this node this voltage current source and this current source are supplying two currents in the same direction. Then I can reduce these two, I can convert these two resistance, these two current sources into a single current source, and between these two terminal, this 2 ohm resistance and this 5 ohm resistances are connected in parallel, and I can reduce this and this resistance into a single resistance. Then our circuit will look like this. I will have a current of 10.5 ampere, and the parallel of this 2 ohm and this 5 ohm will give us a value of 1.43, and this is our 7 ohm resistor. Now I have to calculate I naught that is flowing through this path. How do we calculate I naught? If I apply special current divider rule formula, if I want to calculate, if two resistances are connected in parallel, if I want to calculate the current through this path, I will take the resistance of another path 1.43, then I will add this resistance and this resistance, 7 plus 1.43, and I will divide this whole thing with the total current 10.5, which will give us a value of 1.78 ampere. Or I can apply our original current divider rule, I naught equal to Rp divided by Rx into total subsource current It. Now see here, what is Rp? Rp is the equivalent parallel resistance of this resistance and this resistance, and this will be equal to 1.18 divided by the resistance through which we are calculating current, that is 7, and IT will be equal to 10.5, which will be equal to 1.78. both the formula will give us the same result, and this is our current that is flowing through this 7 ohm resistor. Okay.